Howdy, I'm back. So I've been sitting here thinking, and I want to start on this one. This is cool. I'm going to go a little bit different this time. The boards, most of these fachwerk houses, on the nice ones, they painted the woodwork different colors. So we're going to do that. We're going to paint that. So, let's get started. I can't wait any longer. I'm too excited to paint this thing. I had other projects to work on, but this is going to come first. And let me see here. There's, in case you hadn't guessed, there's a huge stack of stuff in here that needs to be worked on. Trying to be prolific. Alright, let's put that here. Put this over there. We can move this over a little bit. There's just never enough room. I really need a desk like I had in architecture school. What we used in architecture school was a door. We took a door, put it out in front of us, and then we laid out all our stuff on that. And that was ideal. It was beyond ideal. It was totally awesome. Yeah, a lot of space to work. It was good. All right, this is better. See, my brushes are down there. That's what you're missing. Let's do some focus here. Focus adjustment, like one click will make a difference. I'm not sure in which direction, but it's really obvious from experience. Yep. Focus is much better. Okay, so we are back. Let's see, where are we gonna begin here? You know what? This is a 4. Where? I might have a 2. I do have a 2. I got a 2. Let's start with some red. I saw a house like this over in Ulm. Ulm was, had some of the best looking fachwerk houses I've seen in a while. Now, I'm going to build this up in 2 layers. I like doing watercolors where you do like a light wash first and then another layer that's darker. It gives it depth. Nice depth. Also, you can glaze that way, which is also a nice thing. I spent an hour doing Czech learning, the Czech language, and carving for my woodblock printing. Which was also good. Somebody has signed on, welcome. Say something in the stream chat and I'll answer you. I could have started with the sky up here, but there's not much sky. It's mostly
houses here because we're in a city? So I just skip that. Apparently somebody was killed in a small town in North Germany last night from the fireworks. That's not surprising. Germans are obsessed with things that explode. They love explosions. And the firecrackers here would be completely illegal where I came from. I think we're going to do as much work as we can on this one. Then I'm going to finish this, which will officially give me 3 paintings complete for the holidays, which is my goal, and with time to spare. And then I'm not sure what we're going to work on. I got a lot going on here. I got a stack, as usual. And I listened while I was doing the carpeting. I listened to some YouTube videos on art, painting, drawing, etc. That's the positive about YouTube. You can learn any skill you want to learn on YouTube. I think I'm going to be doing a lot of these half-size sheets from now on. I really like working on the bigger pieces of paper. I don't think it takes that much longer to do a painting on them. And I think the results look better. I don't know, we'll see. But then I got all this small paper too. I got a lot of watercolor paper here. Maybe too much. Trying to use it up. So what are we going to talk about? Well, let's see. Once had a very exciting part-time, well, full-time, but only for 5 years career in the military. Which turned me into a massive leftist after seeing Central America. I was not impressed by what capitalism did to that part of the world. I am still a believer in entrepreneurship, and I am still a believer in a definite degree of capitalism. I just don't want to see it go out of control. The bigger the company, the more responsibility it has to its community and its country. That's a principle that does exist here and does not exist so much over there. Now what? Well, let's clean this brush. Now, we have a grayish color here. This is more of a Payne's gray than it is anything else. And I'm going to take some of this cerulean blue and mix it in. I'm going to douse it with a bunch of water. To thin that color down. So I got to wash as opposed to something else. And I'm going to go here. Oh yeah, that's perfect. I'm trying to figure out who this mystery viewer is. It'd be great if people came on and said, hey, it's me. Whoever me is. Yeah, the military career, that was a long time ago. As one of my girlfriends once said, you had a better set of role models for morality than the average working person. And I do think to some extent that was true. It's sunny out here today. It's like, it's pretty warm out. It's like 55 degrees out here, which isn't going to last. I would have taken my free train ticket and gone somewhere, except that it's New Year's Day and everything we're seeing is closed. So, like, if I go to Bregenzburg and find a cool bookstore, it will most certainly be locked up. This is going to be a good one. I'm excited about this one. This is a nice change for the Fachwerk series. What podcasts do I listen to? Well, let's see. I listen to Lex Friedman, who's a computer engineering science professor involved in AI, who had a position at MIT, but I think he gave it up. He You wanted to try to start a company. He has interesting podcasts. I listen to occasionally some Joe Rogan podcasts, depending on who's on. Something about alien spaceships, well, it's usually pretty good. You can get some good people on there for that. And for some science things, some history things, he gets good people. Some current events, he has some interesting types. He's a strange guy. I'm not sure what to make of him. He claims that he's left-wing, or he's something of a Democrat, or he leans in that direction. But in some ways, he's more Republican, which is not inherently evil, although sometimes I wonder about that. I don't really care for his attitude about coronavirus stuff. I think he's been really lucky that he didn't get really sick with that. I do have some respect for his questioning of authority of all these people running around screaming about how everybody, you know, I'm a total supporter of vaccination. But the fact is that countries are paying billions and billions of dollars to these big pharmaceutical companies to make this stuff, and they're getting rich while the world is suffering. And it does lead one to question sort of some of the things about what's going on here. And he does have some questions about that, and I do actually respect that. Those are questions that really should be asked. But unfortunately, they're mostly being ignored. Will be kind of a greenish color. Then we'll get a bright reddish. Let's try this emerald green. That looks good. Let's move some water around here. So I use these cups for different colors of water. I'm not pedantic about it. Listen to Jocko Willink sometimes, ex-Navy SEAL guy, who is also a major in English and reads books about military history on the air, or excerpts. He doesn't read the whole book. He reads excerpts of those books and then interviews the people who wrote them. That can be interesting. I'm trying to think. Sometimes I listen to Stack Overflow. I listen to Dan Carlin podcast once in a while. He's pretty good. I think called the Radio War Nerds that this physics friend of mine turned me on to. Occasionally he shares those with me. I'd like to find some more good podcasts to listen to. I like history. I like art, obviously. I like well-informed discussion about current events and politics and decisions by thoughtful people. It's funny, you know. I was listening to some stuff. Lex Fridman was interviewing Ray Dalio, and I listened to an excerpt today, this morning when I got up. You know, Ray Dalio is a hardcore billionaire capitalist, and he makes far more sense when he talks about what's wrong with America than a lot of Republican politicians do. He's got a far clearer vision, and he basically says, yeah, there's a problem here. At least he admits it. I think there's a difference between astute business people and ideologues. I'm not interested in ideologues of any sort. They just don't do anything for me. If somebody had a good ongoing sci-fi series, I'd listen to that. That would be fun. Yeah, we're making good progress here. This is just shooting along. I'm not much into popular music anymore. I like jazz. I like classical. I like Middle Ages. Not much today on classical rock, although there's stuff that I like. Honestly, there's two sort of, it brings back too many memories that I now find a little bit difficult to contend with, probably because I'm getting older and just reminds me of my youth. And I prefer not to dwell on my youth. I like to be a guy who's looking forwards, not backwards. I don't really see the point in looking backwards. I mean, it's good to do some self-analysis. This went good, this was bad, I need to fix this, that's good. But beyond that, this sort of maudlin rehashing of the past, no, that's not me. Zero interest. I like scientific podcasts are good. Sometimes sure we're gonna have some interesting scientific people on. I give them credit for that. He does have sort of an anti-education attitude in some respects. On the other hand, he sits here and says, hey, I'm not that smart. He's smarter than he gives himself credit for. He asks pretty perceptive questions most of the time on his interviews. This is my good paper. This is Sanders Waterford, my fave. I got a bunch of paper here I want to use up, and then I'm switching over to nothing but Sanders Waterford. Because I think I get the best results with that. It'll be expensive to import it. From England, that's a pain in the ass today due to Brexit, but it's doable. I have noticed. I was down at the art store in Ulm, and Bosner seems to have removed most of its Sanders Waterford product, probably because it's a pain in the ass to get it over here. You can order from Jackson's. And then it has to go through a long process to arrive. Arches is okay. Hanamula is okay. That's more than okay. I like Hanamula for some things. Arches is a little bit more like the way Sanders Waterford takes the water. That's the thing. Sanders Waterford, I find, takes the water the way that I paint better than any other surface. Okay, now, what next? I keep reaching up to stick this brush in my tea. That would be a bad plan. A very bad plan. I think the next thing that we're going to do, we're going to add a little bit of water. Turn this over. We need to lay in some color up here. You know, red brick. This is Rubens Red Kolonski that I got over in Holland years ago. Sometimes I like this brush, and sometimes I don't like it. Right now I like it. My technique's getting better or something. I don't know. Okay. Now we let this dry up a little bit. And now we need some just gray without any blue in it, with very little blue. Yeah, we're working on this upside down. Upside down, you're turning me, blah, 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 blah.
I listen to Michael Francis' podcast sometimes. I have listened to Sammy Graviano a few times. An interesting perspective on things. It's interesting that both of them came to the conclusion that that lifestyle was really BS. Because they are radically different people. Michael Francis is clearly college educated. Sammy Graviano is clearly a street urchin. As Michael Francis says, I was a racketeer, he was a gangster. There's truth to that. I think Michael Francis was probably angry at the government for what they did to his dad and his family. That is a strong bearing on why he became a mobster. And Sammy Graviano actually came out of a very good family, but had a lot of problems in school due to dyslexia. And I think he finally just said, screw it, I'm going to be a mobster. Listen to them once in a while. I don't watch much TV anymore. I'm thinking I should get my cable turned off. And I should just get the basic channels or something. Because I pay extra for this big package of like 150 channels. And basically the programming is terrible. It's really boring. More interested these days in what's on YouTube or Twitch. Yeah, that's something. If anybody knows any interesting Twitch streams, I'd be interested in that. Right now I just follow Bob Ross channel. I don't know who's actually sponsoring it. If it's the evil family that took over his name and his business, then I should probably delist myself. But otherwise, I'm into it.
I'm gonna get a lot of work with a liner brush here, that is for sure. Yeah, television has really just become lamer and lamer and lamer. I watched SEAL Team for a while, which generally I thought was a fairly decent show, at least the first three seasons. First two, definitely. I think it captures some of what it's like to be in the military, at least in special operations, better than other television shows have. But I think some of it is kind of contrived. And then there's always the issue of the fact that special operations isn't supposed to go around advertising itself to people. And that's something that human beings today don't get. That stuff works better when nobody has any idea what's happening. There's a video somewhere on YouTube of some special operations guys with masks on talking about how all these people running around screaming, yelling about, yeah, I was a SEAL, yeah, I was in the Greek Berets, yeah, I was in the Rangers, yeah, blah, 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 blah. It's really compromising their ability to do their missions. And then giving away operating rules, secrets and stuff, it does make a difference. And it does, you know, I mean, one way the Taliban got better at doing what they're doing was studying stuff like that on the internet. And no, I'm not a fan of the Taliban at all. You can write me off on that. Alright. I'm liking this one. This is a good start. I'm going to get a nice big brush here. Douse some serious water into this pan. I'm going to put a thin coat of gray on down here. See, this is more of a pigment-based. You can move this stuff around real easily. You can reposition it. You're not locked in. See? You see that right here? It was real streaky, and now it's not real streaky. Do all kinds of stuff with pigment-based watercolor. You can do all kinds of stuff with dye-based watercolor, but it doesn't work quite the same way. That is for sure. Now, you'll notice I've taken the darkness and I'm spreading it out from the edges into the center. That will force your eye into the center of the picture. It may be a fantasy painting, but it's still paint. If you remember, I went back and I redrew that line there. If you have a straight line drawn on the paper, it's easy to paint against it. But if your line is crooked, your brush will be crooked too. Who would I recommend this video broadcast to? I recommend it as background while you do some art. That's what I recommend. What you should do is turn this on and start drawing your paintings. Anything. I can't draw? Great. Do something abstract. Modern art is huge. You'll sell more paintings than I will. And it'll all be because you don't have any training whatsoever. And hey, that's cool. I mean, people like abstract art. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm really actually seriously thinking about doing some myself. One thing, it makes some money. And for another thing, it might just be fun to throw color on a canvas and see where it goes. There's nothing wrong with that. If that makes you happy, great. It's like Bob Ross says, it's your world, man. Do whatever you want in it. It's fine. Alright, I like that. Now what? Clean the brush. Clean the brush. And consider what we're going to do next. Some brown. Browns are usually earth colors, so they're pigment based. Some of the reds and the blues that are chemical based and greens. I think this is going to be highly successful. That's good. Paper's drying fast. Low humidity here today. Low humidity for me is good humidity. Now we're going to go over and do this other side here. Okay. That's pretty dry. I can probably put in the blue sky. Blue skies, nothing but blue skies is all I see. Yep, Ian Willie Nelson. Willie baby. Aha, lost that brush. Start with something thin. You probably can't see it. I know you can't see it. I don't have this set up right. Probably still can't see it. There's a slight hint of yellow in this blue that's not on the palette. That is smeared around graphite, I think. Yeah, my recommendation is that you should paint along at home to whatever you feel like painting. Doesn't matter what. You want to copy mine? Fine, copy it. Although I will tell you that you probably, there is some use to copying paintings and drawings. You can learn a lot that way, and sometimes that's good. Really, I strongly encourage you to do your own work. It's much harder to sell copies. There's all kinds of legal issues involved. You can get sued for copying a living artist's work in most places. And people are just genuinely more interested when you do your own thing. Let's see what this looks like. I like it. That's going to be a cool painting. All right, this needs to dry a bit. While we're waiting, we can step off and see what else do we need to work on. This needs work. I'm using a different palette here, so I'll have to change. Started out using the traditional white knight palette. Thank you. This is definitely a pigment color. Maybe tomorrow, maybe one of these days we'll do a painting marathon. Let's see how much I can paint. You could do like an 8-hour painting marathon or a 16-hour painting marathon. That might be interesting. This other camera is locked up. What's up with that? I don't know why it does that. Sometimes these cameras lock up. And I have a good computer here. This is a hardcore programming computer. It's not a gaming computer, but it is pretty good. It's got 8 cores, each one of them has 2 threads. It's fast. But I still have some issues with it. I think the software is still ahead of the hardware. I like that, that looks good. I need to do some detail work. To do some very simple brickwork. Basically, it's just a detail work and a few places color has to be added. And this one's done. Then I can write down, yes, I've accomplished 3 paintings this break, which was my list. I will accomplish more than that, I'm pretty sure. But I wanted to accomplish 3. I did do a lot of drawing. I have done a load of useful drawing. Although I could always do more. That's the thing, man. I look at this, I'm like, you know, you could always do more. Well, I was playing this silly browser game. I'll stop that. So now there's more time to draw and paint. Thank you. good to me. So we whip out some more stuff. This will be quite the colorful house. Okay. Something else I saw that needed correcting. And there's a couple of places that need light. I think what we need for that is a 2. We have a 2. A 2 is good. Let's see if there's anything happening here. Basically just details. I'm gonna do those windows. But the rest of it's details. It's basically finished. Yay. We're up. We gotta let that dry before I put the windows in. What can we work on now? This was making progress. I wonder, can we alter the sky at all? It's really hard to push this particular. Yeah, see, you can't really push this around. That's a dye. Two different kinds of cerulean here. One of them's a dye and one of them's a powder. Yeah, it doesn't really change much. Go a little more blue, but that's about it. I don't know, I'm thinking about that one. I need to think about that more, I'm not ready to work on it. And there's this. This needs work. My tea needs some heat, I shall return. Thank you.
grandfather's sweater anymore. Still thinking about this one a little bit. Go for a long marathon here, a couple hours. Pretty much feeling up to it. I wonder, is there a way to put subtitles on here? To put some kind of like message down here? Apparently not. There is something called deck link captions and deck link output. I guess there's a way to stream captions underneath here, which I'm not really interested in doing today. It would be cool if you could have a ticker at the bottom. Warning, art marathon in progress. Decide what comes next here. Aha! I have found a mistake. Then we'll have to be remedied. I've been watching the coronavirus news from the United States, where it seems to be out of control. What is the current status with that stuff over there?
Let's take a look. It's shooting up out of control. It has doubled in a week worldwide. It's at the highest level ever. USA. And the USA, it fell back a little bit yesterday, but it's still at the highest level ever. I think that's going to get a lot worse before it gets better. But it could be the end of the crisis. Unfortunately, it means a lot of people are probably going to die due to their own stupidity, which is always unpleasant. Yeah, Coronas looks bad. Corona looks bad. That's why we're here and not in Prague. I did want to go to Prague, but I don't think it's a good idea. I'm not worried about getting sick and dying. I don't think that'll happen. But I am worried about coming back and being suddenly told, oh, you have to quarantine for 2 weeks. And there is a chance I could get sick and end up in the hospital. Because, well, there's always a chance. Not me, baby. I'm not going to get sick. Ooh. No way. The number of people who have said that, and it is just shocking. Especially because most of them ended up sick, and some of them ended up dead. There was some newspaper report about a guy whose last words in America was, I thought it was a hoax. I don't get that. Why would your government hoax you? Yeah. If I was in Russia, okay, I might believe it. Maybe we're being hoaxed. Although I don't think I believe we're being hoaxed about COVID. It's kind of hard to hoax something in every country in the world. That's just not very doable. So on that one, I would even trust the Russian government without any question. Yes, there is a worldwide pandemic. Whatever, people are weird. So yeah, I'm running out of things to talk about, man. Somebody's gotta give me some feedback here. Give me some feedback. I don't know what these are, but they look cool. And that's really all that counts. I also think it's time to give this palette a bath and start fresh. See, if you're not an artist, just do something like this. Vary the texture. Vary the line length. Some in, some out. Some long, some short. Go back and forth. Make a pattern. I mean, these little fantasy paintings that I'm doing here are not great art. Although they're kind of cool, some of them. Remember what they taught me in architecture school. What you need is a big set of something. Don't just make one. Make two or three or four or 500 of something. Then you'll have something, which is true. That's a good way to think. If you're a painter or whatever, an architect, anybody who's doing this kind of work. I think I've had enough of that color for the time being. Now what? I got ideas for this one. It's coming along good. This one I think has had enough time to dry, so we can come back and put in some windows.
do. Okay. I got an idea here. I got an idea about going full on mixed media. I'm considering this. Instead of painting, I may just take a marker and do this one. Because I can. I'm still thinking about it. Sure would make life easier. I'm not worth considering that. And so small, nobody will ever know it's mixed media. What time is it? 2 o'clock. I've been at this for an hour and a half. A lot more lights on here. Maybe this reflects a more positive world outlook. Maybe I just got tired of painting black windows. Yeah, maybe we'll try one with all the windows on. Bright lights. That's actually a cool idea. I think we might try that. This number two Cosmotop. I love this number two Cosmotop. This is just an awesome brush. Okay. Lights are on. We need some grass. Basically, we just have the detail lining to do, and this one's about finished. That will be cool. Maybe we'll just go all the way on through until it's done. You can probably hear the church bells out there.
2 o'clock. Still plugging away at it here. I don't know why, but suddenly my computer decided to run faster. I don't understand this thing. It's not behaving like it should. Now it's slowing down again. You can probably hear that. Yeah, I think we're gonna try something different this time. Never hesitate to experiment. That's a good rule. Don't just blindly fall into a pattern and just repeat. Rinse and repeat is not the answer. I just put my green and my yellow. That was not terribly smart. Like that, that looks cool. Okay, this is much closer. Let's do a couple of things here. We're gonna try this. We're going to try this. Do I have a 1.5? Yes, I do. I decided that my advice about using Sennelier egg tempera was a bad idea. There's something about this egg tempera that does not seem to harden. I haven't figured that out yet. It does not seem to harden up like some temperas do. Normally, temperas are supposed to harden up, and then they're supposed to be just like hard, like rock hard. I don't know. All right. Now, here's my idea. We're going to turn this upside down. We're going to do lines with this cool marker. This is supposed to be a type of Indian ink. There is a line of watercolor markers called Albrecht Dürer by Faber-Castell, but I could not find them at the store last time I was there. So, we're using this instead. I found this. Technically, this is now no longer a watercolor. It is now called mixed medium. Because I am not a purist, I do not care. Don't be a purist. That is my heartfelt advice to all artists. Do not fall into the trap of being a purist. Try something new. If it doesn't work, throw it away. Okay. we'll see how this looks. Happening out there? No. Not a thing. They did read in the church bills here short a little while ago. For what, I don't know. There's probably some noontime service. This may be the way that I do some of this from now on. I don't know. I don't know. It's an experiment. We're going to decide how I like it. It is definitely easier than doing this with a brush to some degree. Really depends on what you're looking for. Turn over and see what we got. Ooh, I like that. It's got a different look to it. I'll have to ponder that for a bit before I make a decision. Okay. Let's put in the purple. Let that dry, we can sign it. That's probably done. Yeah, that white sennelier is not behaving the way I thought it was going to. That is not the right kind of tempera. I want tempera that once you put it down and it dries, it hardens for 1,000 years, at least. Hey, we have 2 viewers, welcome. Feel free to ask questions. The Oracle of Kloster Lechfeld is busy at the painting table, which means I can answer any question. Doesn't mean you'll get the right answer, but I can answer the questions. What are we gonna do now? We're back here with the same problem. Well, first of all, we're going to fix this by drawing in the place where the signature goes. That's the first thing we're going to do.
This is down in Fussen, remember? This is where Mad King Ludwig built his castle, one of many. You can still erase pencil marks off of something that's been painted. The paint goes down into the paper. The pencil marks rest on the top. Can't scrub at it really hard. It will start taking away paper and stuff. But to some degree you can erase. Alright, we'll figure out how to solve this problem in a bit. I don't have a good idea what the answer is there, but we'll figure it out. Alright. Two viewers. Well, I certainly can't leave now. There's too much going on. Let me go and get the tea. Yeah, let me go throw the tea back and warm again. Now what normally happens is I put the tea on, or actually I put a cold cup of tea in the microwave, and then I forget about it for an hour and then it gets cold again. So basically I just heat it up, cool it down, heat it up, cool it down, heat it up, cool it down, etc. Which is probably not so good for the tea. Now, where is this picture? Here it is. Okay, I need some guides here. All right. Some things need to get darker. Let me see here. I think we need a simple wash. Yeah, we need a simple wash of this. Howdy, second viewer. Yeah, that top part can be gray. Little gaps like that need to be filled in. Alright. Let's see what we can do here. Under is going to be a real dark red. It's going to be super dark red. You can just go ahead and paint it. If darker color is going over a lighter color, just paint it. And basically that's what's happening all over this thing. Except for this window. Oops, that's too much. See, there's some white curtains in here. We have to watch what we do here. This is the one we had to stop the other day because the paper was too wet. There comes a point when the water may not be carrying pigment, but it has soaked in all over the paper. So like, if you make all this wet, then this is wet too. It has some tendency to be wet, and that can be problematic. I mean, we should have like a super painting marathon. Should just go for like 12 hours straight or something. See what happens. Drawings, paintings, just everything, man. That's an idea. Again, this is all coming down a darker color. Maybe Twitch just puts stuff up here. Oh, you have many viewers. You have 2 viewers. Maybe it's just propaganda. I don't know. And decided how this stuff works. Okay, we can stay with the yellow. The brown is okay. Now we need some gray. Let me look here. Everything can be gray except the windows are a light blue. Because they are reflecting the blue sky in front of them. Looks kind of like the Great Smoky Mountains or something. Okay, now what? I think we could probably go ahead and take this way down, like way down. Like that far down.
This is a very thin sheet of paper, and so the water is diffusing through it rapidly. That is one of the advantages of using thicker paper. Okay. And to make this even more ta-da-da, we're going to take this. And we're going to do a black line here, and a black line up here. We'll have to come back over this. It won't really do it. But it'll start in that direction. Okay. Now let's see what we got. Okay. Actually, you know what? This is the wrong brush for this. This is where we need to use this kind of brush, this kind of square brush. Anytime you're doing windows, I recommend the square brush. Yeah, this seems like a really thin piece of paper. It doesn't have written down on here anywhere what it is. I don't like working on thin paper. It doesn't react the same way. This almost feels like it's 90-pound paper, which I cannot stand. It's got to be 140, because I never buy anything less than 140. You get a totally different quality with the heavier paper. It takes the water very, very differently. It's just, it's fundamentally stronger. I don't know what this is. I don't know what kind of paper this is, but the way that it's behaving, it's a very lightweight sheet of paper, which I do not normally use. I don't know where it came from. I probably pulled it off one of the blocks that I have and taped it on here at some point. But I do not remember exactly what the details are.
See, really, for the painting I'm doing, the paper is just too lightweight. It's too big. If this was half this size, then it wouldn't be as bad. The bigger the sheet, the more it needs to weigh. Got decide where we're going next. All right, these windows are all kind of dark. This frame is darker. Water just going everywhere, man. I don't know what's up with that. It's just very damp, this paper. It's super damp. That's problematic.
think what I need to do now is add some green. I don't know, this paper is really wet. It's strangely wet. It is soaking up water like there is no tomorrow. So yeah, choosing the right paper actually makes a big difference. But I cannot explain why this particular sheet is behaving the way that it is. I can only say that it is. I'm just using dirty water for this. And some of this is the graphite that's coming down. I don't know what kind of paper this is, but I'm not happy with it. It just soaks up water like there's no tomorrow and it diffuses all over the place. And so yeah, I don't know what it is. See that? I can't spread any of it around, and I know that's an earth pigment. That's really weird. Behaving very, very strangely here. This is going to end up being a very impressionistic watercolor, more so than I normally like. But I don't know, it may turn out cool. Now see here, we're back to the point, we're on the edge, and the best thing to do on the edge is to bring everything down a little bit into darkness, even if it's not that way in real life. Then it focuses your eye on the middle of the page. This building is white, but I think the painting will look better if it gets darker. So we're going to go with that. Yeah, I don't know what kind of watercolor paper this is. This is weird. This is behaving very, very strangely. But it may work. It may work out great. Yeah, it may work out really good. So yeah, you missed all the good talking earlier, man. You guys should have showed up earlier. I was more talkative. Now I'm all talked out. I'm not even sure what to talk about anymore. And I'm not getting any help from the audience. If you'd ask more questions, I would tell you more things. Is that George Thorogood used to sing, "Don't ask me no questions, I won't tell you no lies." But I'm not George Thorogood. I've met George Thorogood on a number of occasions. I worked for him as a sound engineer. Not as his regular touring engineer, but as the engineer with the PA system. I kind of liked him. He was kind of a nice guy in a really weird kind of way.
rough New Jersey dude. Very New Jersey. I don't know what kind of paper this is, but the water goes everywhere. Whatever this is, I don't want to use it for doing any more landscapes. Now we are deviating from the original picture here quite a bit. And the reason is we need to do that in order to make a successful painting. That's a good start. I think it's got to dry though. It's just so full of water. I don't know what paper that is. That's weird. I got to figure out what kind of paper that is. This one we can sign. I don't know what the number is, so we're going to leave it off. And we're going to cut this thing off. Ta-da! Painting. We have a painting. Boom. That one's done. Put it in the done pile. And what kind of paper is this that we did that on? This paper is all right. This is the L'Aquarelle. This is okay. This is French. This is 140 pounds. I don't know what that other paper is. I'm not sure. Really not sure. Maybe I just loaded the brush down with too much water. I don't know. Here. Let me see here. Where at we is. We have completed the magical three paintings for Christmas break and started a boatload more. You know what? There's back to this thing. This has all kinds of potential here. You can't really see all of it like that. I'm gonna try to make it better so you can see it. My brushes have gone insane. Problem with these painting sessions is that I get really wrapped up in painting. Why do I have this taped? This brush seems to work just fine. Alright, we'll just leave it like that. I put tape on them when they're worn out so that I'm aware that they're not as fine point as they used to be. So yeah, that's basically the painting. There's a little bit missing there, but I think you can live without it. There, you can see a little bit more. Well, where shall we begin? I like a nice red door. See, this doesn't diffuse. This paper, the water strings soaks straight down and then it stops. But it's much heavier paper. This is 300 pound perine. That's less than 140. It says it's 100. I don't buy anything less than 140, but that's acting like it's 90. I don't recommend buying anything less than 140. And really, 300 pound is the best. There are people who make more heavier papers, but I don't really think you need this. $200 is okay. Stratford, what is that? Sanders Waterford makes a 200 pound. That's good. I think we're going to go for a more consistent sort of theme here on this one. If I let that paper thoroughly dry, it should be better.
No question about it. What I want for these stones, this is cobblestone, but I don't feel like painting a million little cobblestones here. So I'm just going to stipple it and then play around with it. Don't mind a few drops flying around, but I don't want them all flying around. I'm gonna go back and do that curb a little darker. I probably should have done a sidewalk there, but I can live with it. But yeah, I'm not going to try to paint every brick on this thing. Oh my God, what a nightmare. I'm going to do some stippling. I'll do some layers of it. I'll let this stipple dry and then do another layer of it. What is it? 3 o'clock. I'm gonna have to think about food sometime soon. All this hard work requires continual feeding. No question about it. Alright. Let's sit and think about this for a minute. I'm gonna go for a more consistent color scheme here. This isn't going to be the psychedelic houses that I was doing earlier. This is going to have green shutters, I know that. But it needs an emerald green.
I happen to have an emerald green right here. Strangely enough. Two hours and 30. Wow, this is really turning into a serious marathon. Well, that's good. Yeah. Oh, we haven't gotten to the oil painting yet. We'll have to do that soon. Yeah, stomach is saying food. I might make tuna fish sandwiches. This for safety. Tuna fish sandwiches sounds good. We'll see how long I can go for. Thank you.
Each shutter is going to be bluish gray. I'm going to do this in two coats. Yes, I'm very bad. I use my clothing as a paint rag all the time. I do that because I'm lazy and because it's watercolor and I do not care that much. These are going to be black shutters. I think these are going to be gray. More water. Painting this. Yeah, I think we'll take a break at 3 hours here. 3 hours is a pretty good transmission time. painting will take all your troubles away. Really will. Any kind of focused activity like this. You forget about all your problems in life. Highly recommend it. Well, I have an interesting idea. We'll see. I have an interesting idea. But I'm not going to share it with you yet. I have to ponder this. Yeah, I gotta say, those tuna fish sandwiches are starting to sound good. Okay, let's turn this around. Ooh, I like that. Mistake. Let's fix it. Cool. Repaired. Okay, now what? Hmm.
think I've reached the eating point. That is the point in the painting where it is time to have a snack or a meal. I like these softer brushes for that. I might even come back over this with some Chinese white or something. Sort of make some highlights in it. But yeah, it's time to go eat. I had a snack at lunch, but not much more. It is now time for further feeding. So we got one painting completely finished. Made a big start on this one. We got a long way to go and a short time to get there. But we are making progress. Let's see how this thing's coming along. This is drying. Yeah. It's still damp. It's still strangely damp. Alright. It is now time to feed the artist. So, I will see you guys later. Thanks for stopping by. I hope you consider subscribing to this feed and sticking around and, you know, use this for inspiration. Oh, that's cool. I could do this or that, or I can do better than that, whatever it takes. So, I'll see you guys later. Thanks for stopping by. Take care.